Dearly beloved brothers, sisters, and friends, in the first place, I give my profound gratitude to our Heavenly Father through our Savior Jesus Christ for the opportunity I have to give a pep talk this morning. My thanks also goes to the officiating minister as well as the administrative committee of Lagos Island Branch for giving me this privilege to speak on behalf of the palliative subcommittee of Lagos Island Branch. We will recall that during our last family meeting, the administrative committee, by the grace of God, talked to us about the palliative or about the need for us to assist members who are in need with palliatives. And this was as a result of what actually happened last year during the COVID-19 pandemic, where a number of members were stranded, but by the grace of God, using members too, some contributions were made and those members were assisted. So the Administrative Committee thought it fit that we should continue in these good works to help members with foodstuffs especially. Some forms were given out and members ticked the forms as they would like to donate by the grace of God. So the palliative subcommittee met. The committee, for those of us who may have forgotten, is headed by Brother Sam Okuro, the vice chairman of the administrative committee of this branch. So the subcommittee met, and we decided first to thank God and thank members who enlisted their names to join this noble cause of supporting other members. Then we also wish to encourage more members to join us in this cause, because indeed it is a worthy cause. The Bible makes us to understand that it is better to give than to receive. So as God has blessed us, no matter how small, let us try to indicate interest to be part of this noble drive. So for those who are interested, who have not yet enlisted their names with the subcommittee, please do well to see me or any member of the subcommittee at the close of today's service. We also wish to inform members that though options were given for members to donate either monthly, bi-monthly, or quarterly, the subcommittee looked at this and we thought it that it would be better we contribute these food items on a monthly basis and give out also on a monthly basis to members who are in need. So while thanking members who indicated monthly, we also wish to thank those who have indicated to donate quarterly or bi-monthly that will be receiving these food items monthly. For these donations, the subcommittee has also decided that for uniformity, we'll be receiving this at the last or on the last Sunday of every month. So this implies that beginning from next Sunday, 26th of September 2021, by the grace of God, at the end of the divine service, the administrative committee will direct and the subcommittee will receive these food items. On receiving these food items on the last Sunday of every month, the subcommittee will be disbursing the food items to members who have indicated interest the following Sunday, that is the next Sunday, the first Sunday of the new month. So I wish to summarize and conclude this my short talk with the kind permission of the officiating minister. I would like to read the devotional guide of yesterday, Saturday, September 18, 2021. We believe that indeed it is God Almighty that directed the Lord's ministry to put these things down, and it has coincided with this pep talk of today. The theme from the devotional guide is spiritual keys to happiness. And the text reads, "Give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down and shaken together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom, that for with the same measure that ye meet, withal shall it be measured to you again," unquote. Luke chapter 6, verse 38. Now let us listen to the comment. "Giving to others who have need, that is, helping others out of genuine concern or empathy, gives happiness to the giver. Our Lord Jesus Christ was quoted by Saint Paul as saying that it is better to give than to receive, according to Acts chapter 20, verse 35. It has been said that an individual has not started living until he can rise above the narrow confines of his individualistic concerns to the broader concerns of all humanity. We recall that Zacchaeus offered to give half of his goods to the poor as a way of relieving himself of the guilt of his past and make him feel happy. Luke chapter 19 from verse 1 to 10. It was to instill in the Israelites the joy of sharing what they have with those who are way down in the social ladder that God Almighty made the law that the leftover produce in the farms be left for the poor, the widows, and the fatherless, according to Leviticus chapter 19, verse 9 and 10. Also, it has been said that happiness is when the greatest goods get to the greatest number. God Almighty requires his people to help to clothe the poor, give food to the hungry, water to the weary, bread to the hungry, and to help the fatherless and widows. Job chapter 22 from verse 6 to 12 and chapter 31, 15 to 22. Quote, love is that condition in which the happiness of another person is essential to your own, unquote, says Robert A. Heine. And Apostle Paul exhorts, quote, but to do good and to communicate, forget not, for with such sacrifices God is well pleased, unquote. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 16. So beloved brothers, sisters, and our friends, let us come with what we have so pledged to give next Sunday by the grace of God. And those who will still like to believe, do want to see me at the end of today's service. I do not intend to go further, but choose to stop here my pep talk. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Francisian. GKS! GKS! So, one of the things what we will do now to help ourselves, I will say the brother don't tell us, wait inside the box, don't open the box to us. The little thing I will say is this. The Bible says that whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy mind. For there is no work, nor reward, nor anything in the grave without thou doest. Those that are dead now, that are sleeping in sleep of death, do they not call them again to come and come up like this? So it is only the living, they shall praise the Lord. So this opportunity that we give to us, beloved brothers and sisters, a time is coming. Nobody will force anybody, nobody will tell anybody to do the work of God. People will look for preachers and they will not see preachers. As at that time, the Bible says, the mighty men will cry bitterly, neither their gold, nor silver, nor wealth will be able to deliver them on that day of God's judgment. So the little one we have to do is the work of God. With a good heart condition, let us contribute it generously by the grace of God. The Bible also says that those that like or love the progress of New Jerusalem, he said they shall prosper. And I will say that the liberal soul shall be made fat, and he that watereth shall be watered also in himself. It is our prayer to our Heavenly Father to provide for members the way we know, both spiritual and material, so that when they call the attention or service of members without hesitation will come out to present things unto God. So we pray by God's Sunday, by God's grace and power, we do our own quarter as grace and power. At this stage, I want to call on the secretary of the branch, Rabudu Yami, who will give us the announcement for the week.